Hello everyone, so I am live with another new video and let's get started. So today I'm going to share with you my experience with NIPER JEE exam 2020. The results are already out and I have obtained All India rank 146 and that's quite good. So today I'm going to share with you my experience with this exam. So it was on 28 September and the time for the exam was 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. And if we talk about the question paper, then I found it mediocre. There were some questions which were unpredictable and so many questions were quite easy and we could tackle them very well. So let's go. So I have divided my paper into the major subjects like pharmacology, pharmaceutics, pharmaceutical analysis, then pharmacognosy, and one major portion is for current affairs and general knowledge questions. So firstly we talk about pharmacology, that there were some questions like antiarrhythmic drugs, then cephalosporin classification, and specifically it was asked about fifth generation cephalosporin. Then if we talk about mechanism of action, then it was about organophosphates mechanism of action, then bicuculine drug which is GABA-A antagonist, and there was one more question about hand and foot syndrome. So this is the major adverse effect of anti-cancer drugs. One more question was about the drugs which are used for ADHD. So these are the major questions that I can recall from pharmacology portion. So I can say that if you have referred the classifications very well, so you could tackle these questions very easily. The sources I have preferred for this subject was that small classification book from K.D. Tripathi. Another book that's available and it's very good, that is Vikas Seth classification. So these two books, I revised them many times and they helped me a lot. Another source which I would like to share here is that Gobind Rai Garg, which is one of the best pharmacologists. So his book is also available, that is Review of Pharmacology. So different MCQs are given there and mnemonics are also available. So that can help you very well. Secondly, there were so many questions from chemistry portion and we can divide them into two major portions like medicinal chemistry and organic chemistry. So questions from medicinal chemistry were like more about their structural features. Like there was the IUPAC name asked of drug carbamazepine. Then there was the pi tautomer of histamine. Another question was about the structure of hydroxychloroquine, which is in the news recently. So these are some questions from medicinal chemistry portion. And if we talk about organic chemistry, so in case of NIPER JEE exam, we have heard that name reactions are the major portion that we need to cover for the preparation of this exam. But this year, only one question was asked. As far as I can recall, there was only one question from name reaction. It was about fitting rearrangement, that what's the product of this reaction. Another questions from organic chemistry were about aromaticity. So different compounds were given as option and we had to select that which of the one is aromatic. There were also some questions about stereochemistry, like which form of N-butane is most stable. So these were some of the major questions from organic chemistry portion. Now if we talk about pharmaceutical analysis, so mainly we have to discuss chromatography portion and spectroscopy portion. So from the spectroscopy, there were questions like which spectroscopy is used for functional group detection. Then there were 2 to 3 questions from NMR spectroscopy. There was one question from chromatography, that which chromatography is dependent on molecular size of the molecules. There was one more question about the reagent that is used in Wohlhardt method. There were 2 to 3 questions about Gidal method. and estimation of nitrogen content and water content. So we can say that these questions were from pharmaceutical analysis. So if you have prepared this subject thoroughly from your syllabus of B Pharmacy, then these questions were quite easy to tackle. Nextly, I would say about pharmaceutics. So I could not recall many questions from this portion, but mainly there was a question from tablet defects that a tablet is not able to come out of the cavity, dye cavity. So from the options, which option is better that the tablet will be easily ejected? So we can say that this one question was majorly from tablet defects. Another question was from residual method for the estimation of absorption coefficient or absorption constant. That residual method, there is a flip-flop phenomena. So different options were given and we had to choose that which one is for flip-flop phenomena. Next subject I would like to discuss is pharmacognosy. There were not so many questions from this subject this year. I can recall 3 to 4 questions and they were from terpenoid. That how many carbon units are present in diterpenoid? So mainly there are 20 carbon units present. Another question was from camphor, that number of isoprene units that are present in camphor. So these are 2 questions I can recall from pharmacognosy. And I could tackle them. I had prepared only one source, that is pharmacognosy book from C.K. Kokate. So I had preferred only this book and I could tackle these questions. Next subject I would like to talk about is biochemistry or biotechnology. So this time there were questions from amino acids. There were like 5 to 6 questions from amino acids. That one question was about proline, that what is proline. Then next question was about the smallest amino acid. One more question was that which amino acid has the maximum potential to be detected in UV spectroscopy. So these are like 5 to 6 questions were from amino acid portion. Then there was one more question was about agarose gel. As we know that it is a polymer, so which is the monomer unit of agarose gel? So these were the questions from biochemistry portion. So these are the major subjects from the pharmaceutical field, and one major portion of this exam is of general knowledge and current affairs. So from the current affairs, we can say that COVID-19 pandemic is the biggest current affair that is in news recently. So there were 3 to 4 questions from this topic, and I can recall that one question was about the binding capacity of SARS-CoV-2, that which protein is responsible for binding of this virus. Then another question was, there were different options and we had to select that which disease is not spread by coronavirus. There were 2 to 3 questions were from hydroxychloroquine. Firstly, it was about the structure, that we had to identify the structure of hydroxychloroquine. Then another question was about the production, that 70% of production of hydroxychloroquine is produced by which country? And the answer will be India. Then there were one more question that was about the properties of hydroxychloroquine. So these are the major questions from HCQ and COVID-19. One more thing we need to remember, that in this year's exam there were many questions from pharmaceutical companies. There were around 10 to 15 questions from reasoning and I got almost all of them right. I will make a separate video for them. This was all about my experience with NIPER JEE exam and it was very good. So if you like this video, then do give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel if you like my content. And don't forget to share it with your friends and classmates. Thank you so much.